Dear friends in Christ, on this most holy night, in which our Lord Jesus Christ passed through death to life, the Church invites her members dispersed throughout the world to gather in vigil and prayer. For this is the Passover of the Lord, in which by hearing his word and celebrating his sacraments, we share in his victory over death. Let us pray. O God, through your Son, you have bestowed upon your people the brightness of your light. Sanctify these new flames, and grant that in this Paschal feast we may so burn with heavenly desires that with pure minds we may attain to the festival of everlasting light. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Rejoice now, heavenly host and choirs of angels, and let your trumpet shout salvation. For the victory of our mighty King. Rejoice and sing now, all the round earth, bright with a glorious splendor. For darkness has been vanquished by our eternal King. Rejoice and be glad now, Mother Church, and let your holy courts in radiant light resound with the praises of your people. All you who stand near this marvelous and holy flame, pray with me to God the Almighty for the grace to sing the worthy praise of this great light. Through Jesus Christ, his Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with him in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give him thanks and praise. It is truly right and good, always and everywhere, with our whole heart and mind and voice to praise you, the invisible, almighty, and eternal God, and your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. For he is the true Paschal Lamb, who at the feast of the Passover paid for us the debt of Adam's sin, and by his blood delivered your faithful people. This is the night when you brought our fathers, the children of Israel, out of bondage in Egypt, and led them through the Red Sea on dry land. This is the night when all who believe in Christ are delivered from the gloom of sin and are restored to grace and holiness of life. This is the night when Christ broke the bonds of death and hell and rose victorious from the grave. How wonderful and beyond our knowing, O God, is your mercy and loving kindness to us, that to redeem a slave, you gave a son. How holy is this night, when wickedness is put to flight, and sin is washed away. It restores innocence to the fallen, and joy to those who mourn. It casts out pride and hatred, and brings peace and concord. How blessed is this night, when earth and heaven are joined, and man is reconciled to God. Holy Father, accept our evening sacrifice, the offering of this candle in your honor. May it shine continually to drive away all darkness. May Christ, the morning star who knows no setting, find it ever burning. He who gives his light to all creation, and who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Let us hear the record of God's saving deeds in history, how he saved his people in ages past. And let us pray our God will bring each of us to the fullness of redemption. A reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. And God saw that the light was good. And God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. And God said, "Let there be a dome in the midst of the waters, and let it separate the waters from the waters." So God made the dome and separated the waters that were under the dome from the waters that were above the dome. And it was so. God called the dome sky. And there was evening and there was morning, the second day. And God said, "Let the waters under the sky be gathered together into one place, and let the dry land appear." And it was so. God called the dry land earth, and the waters that were gathered together he called seas. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let the earth put forth vegetation, plants yielding seed, and fruit trees of every kind on earth that bear fruit with the seed in it." And it was so. the earth brought forth vegetation, plants yielding seed of every kind, and trees of every kind bearing fruit with the seed in it. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the third day. And God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate the day from the night, and let them be signs and for seasons and for days and years. Let them be lights in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth." And it was so. God made the two great lights, the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night and the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fourth day. And God said, "Let the waters bring forth swarms of living creatures, and let birds fly above the earth across the dome of the sky." So God created the great sea monsters and every living creature that moves, and every kind, with each the water swarm, and every winged bird of every kind. And God saw that it was good. God blessed them, saying, "Be fruitful and multiply, and fill the waters and the seas, and let the birds multiply on the earth." And there was evening, and there was morning, the fifth day. And God said, "Let the earth bring forth living creatures of every kind, cattle and creeping things and wild animals of the earth of every kind." And it was so. God made the wild animals of the earth of every kind, and the cattle of every kind, and everything that creeps upon the ground of every kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let us make humankind in our image, according to our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and all the other wild animals of the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth." So God created humankind in his image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them and said to them, "Be fruitful and multiply and fill the earth and subdue it and have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the birds of the air and over every living thing that moves upon the earth." So God said, "See, I have given you every plant yielding seed that is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree with seed in its fruit. You shall have them for food. And to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps on the earth, everything that has the breath of life, I have given every green plant for food." And it was so. God saw everything that he had made, and indeed, it was very good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all their multitude. And on the seventh day, God finished the work that he had done, and he rested on the seventh day from all the work that he had done.
Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird had spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning. Praise for them springing fresh from the The rains new fall, sunlit from heaven, like the first dewfall on the first grass. Praise for the sweetness
of the wet garden, sprung in completeness where his feet passed. Mine is the sunlight, mine is the morning, born of the one light Eden saw play. Praise with elation, praise every morning, God's recreation of a new day.
Let us pray. O God, who wonderfully created and more wonderfully restored the dignity of human nature, grant that we may share the divine life of him who humbled himself to share our humanity, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. As Pharaoh drew near, the Israelites looked back, and there were the Egyptians advancing on them. In great fear, the Israelites cried out to the Lord. They said to Moses, "Was it because there were no graves in Egypt that you have taken us away to die in the wilderness? What have you done to us, bringing us out of Egypt? Is this not the very thing we told you in Egypt? Let us alone and let us serve the Egyptians. For it would have been better for us to serve the Egyptians than to die in the wilderness." But Moses said to the people, "Do not be afraid. Stand firm and see the deliverance that the Lord will accomplish for you today. For the Egyptians whom you see today, you shall never see again. The Lord will fight for you, and you have only to keep still." Then the Lord said to Moses, "Why do you cry out to me? Tell the Israelites to go forward. But you lift up your staff, you stretch out your hand over the sea and divide it, that the Israelites may go into the sea on dry land. Then I will harden the hearts of the Egyptians so that they will go in after them. And so I will gain glory for myself over Pharaoh and all his army, his chariots and his chariot drivers. And the Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord when I have gained glory for myself over Pharaoh, his chariots and his chariot drivers." The angel of the Lord who was going before the Israelite army moved and went behind them. And the pillar of cloud moved from in front of them and took its place behind them. It came between the army of Egypt and the army of Israel. And so the cloud was there with the darkness, and it lit up the night. One did not come near the other all night. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea. The Lord drove the sea back by a strong east wind all night and turned the sea into dry land. And the waters were divided. The Israelites went into the sea on dry land. The waters formed a wall for them on their right and on their left. The Egyptians pursued and went into the sea after them, all of Pharaoh's horses, chariots, and chariot drivers. At the morning watch, the Lord in the pillar of fire and cloud looked down upon the Egyptian army and threw the Egyptian army into panic. He clogged their chariot wheels, so that they turned with difficulty. The Egyptians said, "Let us flee from the Israelites, for the Lord is fighting for them against Egypt." Then the Lord said to Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea, so that the water may come back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and chariot drivers." So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and at dawn the sea returned to its normal depth. As the Egyptians fled before it, the Lord tossed the Egyptians into the sea. The waters returned and covered the chariots and the chariot drivers, the entire army of Pharaoh that had followed them into the sea. Not one of them remained. But the Israelites walked on dry land through the sea, the waters forming a wall for them on their right and on their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel that day from the Egyptians, and Israel saw the Egyptians dead on the seashore. Israel saw the great work that the Lord did against the Egyptians. So the people feared the Lord and believed in the Lord and in his servant Moses. Then Moses and the Israelites sang this song to the Lord. I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. Horse and rider he has thrown into the sea.
Land, let my people go. Oppressed so hard they could not stand, let my people go. Go now, Moses, way down in Egypt land. Hello, Pharaoh, let my people go. The Lord told Moses what to do, let my people go, to lead the children of Israel through, let my people go. Go now, Moses, way down in Egypt's land, tell all Pharaoh to let my people go. They journeyed on at his command, let my people go, and came at length to Canaan's land, let my people go. Go down, Moses, way down in Egypt land, let old Pharaoh let my people.
Once delivered by the power of your mighty arm, your chosen people from slavery under Pharaoh, to be a sign for us of the salvation of all nations by the water of baptism. Grant that all the peoples of the earth may be numbered among the offspring of Abraham and rejoice in the inheritance of Israel. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. I will take you from the nations and gather you from all the countries and bring you into your own land. I will sprinkle clean water upon you, and you shall be clean from all your uncleanness, and from all your idols I will cleanse you. A new heart I will give you, a new spirit I will put within you, and I will remove from your body the heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh. I will put my spirit within you and make you follow my statutes and be careful to observe my ordinances. Then you shall live in the land that I gave to your ancestors, and you shall be my people, and I will be your God.
Life anew, that I may love.
Almighty and everlasting God, who in the Paschal mystery established the new covenant of reconciliation, grant that all who are reborn into the fellowship of Christ's body may show forth in their lives what they profess by their faith, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zephaniah. For I will leave in the midst of you a people humble and lowly. They shall seek refuge in the name of the Lord, the remnant of Israel. They shall do no wrong and utter no lies, nor shall a deceitful tongue be found in their mouths. Then they will pasture and lie down, and no one shall make them afraid. Sing aloud, O daughter Zion. Shout, O Israel. Rejoice and exult with all your heart, O daughter Jerusalem. The Lord has taken away the judgments against you. He has turned away your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You shall fear disaster no more. On that day it shall be said to Jerusalem, do not fear, O Zion. Do not let your hands grow weak. The Lord your God is in your midst, a warrior who gives victory. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will renew you in his love. He will exult over you with loud singing, as on a day of festival. I will remove disaster from you, so that you will never bear reproach for it. I will deal with all your oppressors at that time. And I will save the lame and gather the outcast, and I will change their shame into praise and renown it in all the world. At that time, I will bring you home, at the time when I gather you, for I will make you renowned and praised among all the peoples of the earth. When I restore your fortunes before your eyes, says the Lord. Let us read Psalm 98 together in unison. It can be found in your PDF or on page 727 of the prayer book. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. With his right hand and his holy arm, he has won for himself the victory. The Lord has made known his victory. His righteousness has he openly shown in the sight of the nations. He remembers his mercy and faithfulness to the house of Israel. And all the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. Shout with joy to the Lord, all you lands. Lift up your voice, rejoice and sing. Sing to the Lord with the harp and the voice of song, with the trumpets and the sound of the horn. Shout with joy before the King of the Lord. Let the sea make a noise and all that is in it, the lands of those who dwell therein. Let the rivers clap their hands, and let the hills ring out with joy before the Lord. When he comes to judge the earth, in righteousness shall he judge the world and the peoples with equity. Let us pray. O God of unchangeable power and eternal light, look favorably on your whole church, that wonderful and sacred mystery, by the effectual working of your providence. Carry out in tranquility the plan of salvation. Let the whole world see and know that things which were cast down are being raised up, and things which had grown old are being made new, and that all things are being brought to their perfection by him through whom all things were made, your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore let us keep the peace, not with old leaven, neither with the leaven of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia. Christ, being raised from the dead, dieth no more. Death hath no more dominion over him. For in that he died unto sin once. But in that he liveth unto God. Likewise reckon ye also yourselves to be dead indeed unto sin, but alive unto God through Jesus Christ our Lord. Alleluia. 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 Christ is risen from the dead, and became the first fruits of them that slept. For since by man came death, by man came also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, who made this most holy night to shine with the glory of the Lord's resurrection, stir up in your church that spirit of adoption, which is given to us in baptism, that we, being renewed both in body and mind, may worship you in sincerity and truth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
You may be seated for the readings. A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Therefore, we have been buried with him by baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, so we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him so that the body of sin might be destroyed, and we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For whoever has died is freed from sin. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death he died to sin, once for all. But the life he lives to God. So you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord, descending from heaven, came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised, as he said. Come, see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples. He has been raised from the dead, and indeed he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you." So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy, and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please be seated. Isn't the Easter Vigil just an absolutely beautiful liturgy? It starts in the very beginning with the stories that we've known and we've heard since we were children, the stories of the beginning of creation, the stories of the parting of the Red Sea. I mean, these are stories that we cherish, the church cherishes, and that we pass on to our children and our grandchildren. Stories are so incredibly important. And so we also hear in the gospel the story of Jesus' resurrection. And so it's the stories of our lives that are sacred. It is the stories that connect us. It is the stories that bring us into almost a whole other realm. And so Easter liturgy and the Easter vigil has a special place in my heart, simply because of hymn 208 that we just sang, "The strife is o'er, the battle done." That brings back the memory of a very dear neighbor. She lived right next door to us. Her name was Carol Ray. She was like a grandmother to me. And so Carol had emphysema and had a permanent tracheostomy, but her bedroom window faced my bedroom window. And so I was a teenager and spent a lot of time in my bedroom, like most teenagers do. And so I would open my window and I could yell across my yard and talk to Carol. And so Carol and I, we were good friends from the time I was probably 3 or 4 years old. I always felt like I could go and sit with Carol, and they had a cocker spaniel that she taught how to eat poached eggs off of a spoon, and his name was Snoopy, and so I got to teach Snoopy how to sit and how to shake paws, and so she was like the grandmother that I didn't really have. And so she got sick, and she ended up in an institution, in the state institution, and basically by herself. And so it was an October morning, and she suddenly decided that she wanted to be baptized. And so we got word that she had been baptized, and within maybe 2 days, Carol passed away. And so she lived a really very difficult, hard life. Addiction, cigarette smoking, chronic illness just riddled her physical nature, but her spirit always shined through. The love of Mrs. Ray towards me just kept me alive and reminded me time and time again that I was worth it and that I was loved by her almost unconditionally. And so her very last request was to be baptized. And so she gets baptized and then she dies. And as a 16-year-old, I was shattered. I just couldn't understand how in the world somebody could be baptized and then mere days later, she dies. But every Easter vigil, when I hear this song being sung, it was a song that was sung at her funeral, and it really is a song that speaks to her life. That the battle was done, the addictions, the sadness, the broken family, the horrors of her physical life were over, and Carol Ray sits now with God. But those stories of her constantly bring me great joy. And so when I sit with a family during funeral preparation, the very first thing that we do is we start talking about stories and we start telling stories. And it's amazing how you can take such a grief-ridden experience, such a moment that's so somber, and suddenly through the sharing of stories, it becomes alive with life again. And that's what Easter is. That's what the Easter vigil is. We start in the darkness, we start in the tomb, and as we hear these stories, life begins to grow again. And so the stories of people who have gone before us, the stories of our loved ones, those are the gifts that God continues to give us. That is the new life that resides in all of us. Those little tiny Easter moments that we experience throughout the year that maybe we don't realize is when we get to sit down and some of those stories come back to us and we get to share them with our children or our grandchildren, from relatives and friends who have died and now sit with God. And so as we begin to celebrate this Easter season and we're in isolation and some of you are stuck in your home with your family, so you're not looking at isolation, you're looking at absolutely the opposite, right? You guys are stuck together and you're like, oh, please get me apart. This is the time to start talking about those stories. So on Easter morning and the weeks to come, as you gather as a family, or as you FaceTime, or as you talk to your extended family, think about the stories. Share those stories and see how it brings you back together again. See how it brings those people who have died back into your hearts and into your memories and almost brings them back to life in a certain spiritual way for you.
And so tell those stories. Those are the gifts from God. Those are the blessings that God gives us, are the memories and those stories. Tell them, find peace in them, and find joy in them.
Amen. Please stand as you are able. Our liturgy continues with the renewal of baptismal vows found in your PDF or in the Book of Common Prayer on page 292. Through the Paschal mystery, dear friends, we are buried with Christ by baptism into his death and raised with him to newness of life. I call upon you, therefore, now that our Lenten observance is ended, to renew the solemn promises and vows of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and all his works, and promised to serve God faithfully in his holy Catholic Church. Do you reaffirm your renunciation of evil and renew your commitment to Jesus Christ?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting.
Will you continue in the Apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread, and in the prayers?
I will, with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will, with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will, with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will, with God's help.
May Almighty God, the Father of Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed upon us the forgiveness of sins, keep us in eternal life by his grace, in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
Please join me for the prayers of the people, Form 6, found in your PDF, or in the Book of Common Prayer on page 392. We stand during the Easter tide for the prayers of the people. In peace, we pray to you, Lord God, for all people in their daily life and work,
for our families, friends, and neighbors, and for those who are alone,
for this community, the nation, and the world,
for all who work for justice, freedom, and peace,
for the just and proper use of your creation,
for the victims of hunger, fear, injustice, and oppression,
for all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble,
for those who minister to the sick, the friendless, and the needy,
for the peace and unity of the Church of God,
for all who proclaim the gospel and all who seek the truth,
for Michael, our presiding bishop, and Andrew, our bishop, and for all bishops and other ministers,
for all who serve God in his church.
I invite your prayers of thanksgiving or intercession, either aloud or in the holy silence of your hearts. Hear us, Lord,
for your mercy is great.
I now invite you to share a sign of peace with those in your immediate family. And also, I'd like to suggest that in this time of separation, that you send a text message or call someone in the next day or so and just share that sign of peace with them. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Before we go into a prayer for communion with Christ, a teaching moment. And so this is part of the heritage of the Episcopal Church and the Roman Catholic Church. This is something that has been part of both religions for a long time, but has kind of been laid down because we really haven't needed to use it. And so this particular prayer comes from the prayer book for the armed services. And its intent is for the military or for people who are unable to receive the sacrament in its physical form. And what we are doing in this prayer is we are opening our hearts and our souls and our spirits up so that we may receive the grace of God as if we were receiving the body and blood of Christ. We open ourselves up and open our lives up to receive that same grace that is being celebrated somewhere in the world. The heavenly banquet, as many of us know, goes on 24/7, 365 days a week, and a pandemic cannot affect the heavenly feast and the heavenly banquet. And so this prayer, this practice, is for us to be a part of that and to receive the grace that comes through the sacrament. So let us pray.
In union, O Lord, with your faithful people, at every altar of your church, where the Holy Eucharist is now being celebrated, I desire to offer to you praise and thanksgiving. I remember your death, Lord Christ. I proclaim your resurrection. I await your coming in glory. And since I cannot receive you today in the sacrament of your body and blood, I beseech you to come spiritually into my heart. Cleanse and strengthen me with your grace, Lord Jesus, and let me never be separated from you. May I live in you, and you in me, in this life and the life to come. Amen.
May Almighty God, who has redeemed us and made us his children through the resurrection of his Son, our Lord, bestow upon you the riches of his blessing.
Amen.
May God, who through the water of baptism has raised us from sin into newness of life, make you holy and worthy to be united with Christ forever.
Amen.
May God, who has brought us out of bondage to sin into true and lasting freedom in the Redeemer, bring you to your eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, rest upon you and those you love, here on earth and in heaven, today and always.
Amen.
Christ is risen today.
be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.